Cheap and Cheerful, and today we'll continue our look into the best possible thermal camera for the least amount of money. I'll be covering an array of models from those $35 science experiments from AliExpress to this remarkably capable 192 by 192 pixel unit that I bought for only 80 bucks that I'll be giving away at the end of this video. We'll be comparing it to my current cheapest recommendation, the Mileseey TR10 at around 150 to 200 bucks, and the more powerful TR256B and C, plus my tooltop Trojan horse, which I do not recommend, and this absolute beast of a unit, the Thor 001, and its cheaper friend, the 002, given to me for review by Thermal Master. Links are in the description for all these models. While we're at it, we'll be chasing after little people in the woods, checking your bathroom for leaks, your walls for cold spots, and a circuit board for blown up bits. All that and more coming up next. Okay, so here's a table of all the units I'll be discussing comparing today. Several I have with me, others based on the specs and word on the street. Alrighty, first with the most exciting item I've got in my hands today, the Thor 001, given to me for review by Thermal Master. This is not a sponsored review. All opinions will be my own and they will not be seeing the review before I publish it. Opening this up for the first time, it feels serious. It comes in this proper hard case, which right off the bat gives you an impression you're buying a tool and not a toy. It's something that's meant to be protected and used on a job site. Inside you'll find a decent manual, good quality cable, and in this Thor 001 model, a macro lens attachment for electronics diagnosis, which I'll demonstrate shortly. Taking it out in hand, it feels beefy and solid. At 710 grams, it's about 150 grams heavier than its competition in the Mileseey TR256, probably because it's got a metal alloy chassis all the way to the base here, where it's got a quarter inch screw mount, so it'll fit most camera tripods. I wouldn't call it heavy though. It feels just right, not delicate at all. It's got a rubberized outer shell, IP54 rated, which means it can handle a bit of dust and dirt and a little bit of rain, so you don't have to baby it, and all the ports are sealed here up the top. Pretty much everything about it, from the chunky trigger to the buttons you can press well with big gloves on, just screams, I'm built for work. With its regular price at $599, it's a far jump from our usual cheapies, but this is a professionally spec'd model. When compared with the equivalent cameras at my local tool store, $2,000. $4,000, $9,000, it starts to look like a pretty good deal, especially if you need serious accuracy and a proper factory calibration. But like many of us, it also has a cheap friend whose regular price is much lower at $399, and I saw it even lower than that at the recent Amazon Prime Day sale. But that's over now and might not be repeated, so tough luck. The cheaper version of this is almost identical in every way to this model. It looks exactly the same and its features are very, very close. It just doesn't ship with the macro lens attachment for zooming into tiny electronics components. And as per my table, its specifications are still very high, just not quite as hardcore as its brother, the 01 that I'm holding right now. So it's potentially a good buy, though we'll see how it performs against another 256 by 192 pixel resolution camera, my own tooltop that I purchased myself many moons ago, and on paper, the Mileseey TR256B and C, which I believe is probably its closest competition price-wise. Links for both the Thor 001 and 002 are in the description. Now, something that came up while making these data sheets was I was struggling to find the actual weight of the 02 model. I knew it should be pretty close to the 01 at 710 grams, but according to Tech Radar, a very respectable website, the 02 weighs at 2.9 kilograms or 6.5 pounds. Now, no, it doesn't weigh anything near that. Even the whole package in the box only weighs 1.5 kilos or just over 3 pounds. Then the other source I found was Igor's lab. Now, he said 375 grams or about half the Thor 001. Really? It's 99% identical, metal frame and everything. It seems a bit light. Eventually, I got the answer from Thermal Master themselves, and the correct weight is 710 grams, identical to the Thor 001, which makes sense since it's basically the same thing. So what on earth were all those other guys saying? 2.9 kilos, 375 grams? I've got no idea, but comment below if you've got a theory of what's going on there. So moving on, the Thor has this really neat slide across lens cover, much nicer than the plastic flap you see on the other cameras like this one. It seems like it's going to bust off if you hit it on the side. It also has a 32 gigabyte SD card for storing your recordings, photos and videos, and it records audio with noise reduction, so you can take voice notes as you go. It's got this big, beautiful 3.5 inch 640 by 480 IPS screen, a highly sensitive and accurate thermal sensor, which we'll get into in a moment, plus a regular camera lens so you can see the thermal overlaid with a real life view. And then you have the GoJoYo. So the unboxing here is much more in line with the price. I pay the equivalent of $80 US here in Australia, but the US dollar value due to tariffs, the lowest I've seen is about 110 bucks. The device itself is tiny, weighing only 18 grams. It really is just a sensor with a USB-C plug in a metal case. Your phone provides the screen, the battery, and the brains. It also comes with a lightning adapter here for older iPhones and iPads. Now, I bought this one myself, and I'll be giving it away at the end of this episode, so let's hope it doesn't suck, because either way, I'm going to send it. Now, the USB-C connector on this one is quite stubby, and some users have reported that extension cables won't work. So if your phone case is kind of bulky, you might consider ordering something a little bit slimmer at the same time, maybe one of these clear cases, which seem to work just fine. Now, before we do some tests and comparisons, let's quickly cover the three most important specs you need to understand when buying any thermal camera. First of all is resolution. Just like a regular camera, more pixels is more better, but you've got to be careful as it's a very common tactic for dodgy sellers to confuse you by quoting the LCD screen resolution. Then you've got scams like these far too cheap $35 US so-called thermal cameras. Check the detailed specs though, and its resolution is only 8x8 pixels. That looks a bit like this. It's ridiculous. The same listings will usually have upgraded models with more pixels for about 50 bucks, claiming 320 by 480 pixels, but of course, that's just the screen resolution. The thermal sensor resolution is a super lame 32 by 24, which looks a bit like this. Not useful for anything past a kid's science project, maybe. At minimum, you'll want to get a camera with 192 by 192 pixels to get any kind of use out of it. Or if you pay a little more, 256 by 192, it's a much more natural looking picture and ratio. The second most important spec is the thermal sensitivity, or NETD, which is a noise equivalent temperature difference. It's just the sensitivity of the thermal sensor, measured in millikelvins, and it makes a bigger difference than you might think. I'll show you exactly what I mean in our first test. And finally, there's temperature range, accuracy, and calibration, all fairly self-explanatory. Hobbyists, these ones might be less important, but for many, it's going to be crucial. Those are the basic specs, but what difference do they make in the real world? Let's find out. For the first test, I'd already planned to take my family on a short trip up the mountains in the hope of seeing some snow because it's winter in Australia, but there was none of that to be found. Though we were still able to stop by a giant Californian redwood forest that was planted in the 1930s, presumably for lumber. Inside the forest is a kind of creepy calm, almost alien and fairly cold, perfect for testing the capabilities of thermal cameras with a high-tech game of hide and seek. The goal, could I spot my kids hiding using only thermal vision? The results were fascinating. Both the GoJoYo on screen now and the Thor on screen now easily picked out the warm signature hiding behind a tree trunk, though the GoJoYo's lack of thermal sensitivity meant they appeared like a giant blob with no discernible shape. The Thor 001's picture in comparison was shockingly good. The detail it was able to capture, even as they hid behind scrub and branches, was incredible. People off in the distance, more than 100 meters away, were also able to be picked up, even by the GoJoYo, just with less detail. Looking at our chart, the Thor 001 clearly has the highest sensitivity and the Mileseey's the lowest. For the TR10 model, I think this is entirely forgivable for the price. It's plenty good. But if you're paying 600 bucks for the TR256C model and getting the same sensitivity as the $150 TR10 model, Well, that's kind of lame. Strangely, the cheaper, smaller Mileseey TR256B actually has a higher sensitivity rating, making that smaller, cheaper model better value than the C model, in my opinion. Okay, next up, diagnosing electronics. So thermal cameras have always been a kind of cheat code when diagnosing faults in circuit boards, because when a component fails, it tends to glow red hot. I'm going to demonstrate this using my Q6 do-it-yourself power bank from AliExpress. It's a genuinely good unit that I've been meaning to do a video on, since it's the only one I know that's powerful enough to charge a laptop, a full 100 watts legit power delivery, while still being quite cheap, like 20 or 25 bucks or so US. So you just need to chuck in 6 21700 batteries and you're good to go. Links in the description. Now, looking at this when it's running red hot and charging my laptop, you can see the batteries changing color the closer they get to the circuit board until they reach the toroid, which is white hot, normal for a toroid coil under load and easy to spot since it's a larger component. Looking at it with a higher resolution tool top is better, but I don't recommend the tool top since it came with a bunch of viruses pre-installed on the internal storage. So without any attachments, the Thor does a pretty good job, as we can see here. This is basically what the Thor 002 is going to look like, but the Thor 01 comes with this macro lens attachment. So popping that on and we immediately get a more detailed and zoomed in perspective, easily seeing each individual component on the board, perfect for finding and replacing all the duds. Okay, so next, checking your home insulation. This was a shock. I knew it wasn't great from being up in the roof before and seeing it from a distance, but wow. Basically, the builder couldn't be stuffed getting it right into the corners, so any heat I'm paying for is just being sucked right through the plasterboard. Quality Australian house building. Now, these are huge glaring gaps, so all the cameras were able to see this, including the super cheap GoJoYo, though the Thor really illustrated the point, allowing me to see exactly what was going on. Shocking. Moving on to the shower, and if you've ever had a leaky shower, sometimes finding the source exactly where it's coming from can be a major headache if it's not immediately obvious. So having a thermal camera can make a big difference. Now, I used to have a leak in this corner, which thankfully has been fixed, and all of them were able to confirm that none of the hot water was getting out unless I let it. I'm not sure if the GoJoYo could help track down a much smaller hole, but the Thor was able to see in incredible detail even the tiny droplets of water hitting the tiles. Really cool. Okay, so after putting these through the paces, which ones would I buy? Firstly, if you only need the simplest, bare minimum thermal camera for a once-off curiosity or faffing around, then if you can get away with a GoJoYo for as cheap as I did, around half the price of a TR10, then why wouldn't you? It's perfectly capable and it's got a decent resolution. That said, the TR10 is still my budget king. For the specs and the quality, I've not yet seen anything cheaper that'll get the job done. It's a solid buy. Just don't expect magic. Now, if you can afford it, I'd highly recommend spending more and getting a higher resolution model with a bigger screen and better sensitivity. All things being equal, look, the Thor is objectively the better unit with the larger, higher resolution screen, more rugged alloy build, internal lens cover, camera mounts, 32 gig storage and the case. My advice would be get the Thor 002 if you can afford it, and if you can't, consider waiting. But if you manage to pick the 256B for significantly less, then you've done well. It's a solid unit and I still recommend it. Finally, if you need serious accuracy, maybe you run a business or frequently repair electronics, then the Thor 001 presents an extremely appealing option. 35 millikelvin sensor, 1.5% accuracy, the macro lens for electronics and everything else you get with the Thor 002, it's very competitive and honestly, I was struggling to find things I didn't like with this thing. Finally, the giveaway. Originally, I'd arranged for a dongle-based camera from a popular manufacturer and I was going to give it away, but that fell through. So I purchased this one myself so that the person who responded to my announcement wouldn't be stiffed. And since there was only one Australian who responded, a requirement in the giveaway, the thermal camera is yours. If you'd like to contact me at this email address, I'll arrange for postage to your address. Congratulations, and it even turned out to be a pretty neat device. Well, I hope that's been helpful if you're shopping around for one of these. Links for all items are in the description if you'd like to help out the channel. Be cool, be kind, and I'll see you next time.